Honorable President, I may be permitted to read few starting and ending paragraphs in the English version of your address. The rest of the address may be considered as read. Honorable members, it gives me immense pleasure to address the joint sitting of the two houses of parliament. In the annals of our democracy, 2019 is an important milestone. We, the people of India, are celebrating the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, the father of the nation, this year. 13th April this year will also mark 100 years of the tragic massacre at Jallianwala Bagh. On behalf of the entire nation, I bow to pay tribute to all those martyrs who sacrificed their lives for a bright future for all of us. This year, our country will also celebrate 70th anniversary of the Constitutional Day. It is in this historic central hall that the illustrious architects of our Constitution had sculpted the Constitution of India. This year, we are also celebrating 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev Ji, who taught us to lead our lives with the spirit of service and goodwill. I am glad that our country is following the dreams of Gandhi Ji to build an inclusive society based on ethics and principles. Our nation is moving ahead, guided by the ideals of social and economic justice as enshrined in the Constitution by Baba Saheb Dr. Ambedkar. The efforts of my government clearly reflect a belief in an egalitarian society as exposed by Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia, the torchbearer of the public conscience against the politics of exploitation. Honorable members, this year our nation will provide a decisive impetus to our march towards a powerful, self-reliant and prosperous 21st century New India. The biggest festival of democracy will be celebrated this year in the form of general election. Though this August house, I convey my best wishes to the young voters who will cast their votes for the first time in this century. All citizens of India, as citizens, they will exercise their right to vote and determine the direction of the national policies and decisions. My government's efforts are ushering in change for the betterment of the country, and this process will continue. With the blessings and support of 130 crore Indians, my government have commenced its journey towards building a new India. A new India where every person has access to basic amenities. A new India, every person is healthy, secure, and educated. A new India where every person gets an opportunity to nurture his or her talent and has equal opportunities of advancement. A new India where every child progresses in life without any deprivation and every daughter feels safe. A new India where every person gets justice with dignity. A new India which commands the respect of the entire world. Honorable members, let us all come together to pave the way for a new India and take India to glorious new heights in the 21st century. Jai Hind!